Good morning and welcome to Frederick at its best. I'm Frederick County Executive Jan Gardner. And you can see I'm joined by a lot of people here today. And we're joining with Americans across our nation to honor Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., a visionary who changed the course of history in our country through his advocacy of equal rights and freedom for everyone. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. is widely considered to be one of the most influential leaders of our time, and certainly the leader of the American Civil Rights Movement. He fought to overturn segregation laws and to eliminate social justice and economic differences, really for all people. We are honored, really, I'm truly honored to have all of you join us today, representing a variety of organizations, to stand in recognition of Dr. King and all of his many accomplishments. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s legacy lives on through each person here today, and actually through all of us in the community as we walk in his footsteps and live the dream he proclaimed. His influence can be felt in every street and on every avenue in Frederick County as we work together for civil and equal rights for all citizens. The Frederick County Human Relations Commission is with us here today, and they take the lead in our county government on social justice and human rights issues in Frederick County. And they do this in many ways, including through events, forums, Human Rights Day, to really continue to promote the message that Dr. Martin Luther King gave to us. In recognition of Dr. King's incredible legacy of service to all, Congress designated the Martin Luther King Jr. federal holiday as a National Day of Service in 1994. Taking place each year on the third Monday in January, the Martin Luther King Day of Service is the only federal holiday observed as a National Day of Service and is known as a day on, not a day off. The upcoming commemoration of the Martin Luther King Day of Service is on Monday, January 16th, and it's an opportunity to remember that history and to recommit ourselves as citizens by volunteering in service to one another. It's also a time to recognize and consider how much work still remains to fulfill Dr. King's dream. And maybe now, more than ever, it is time for Americans to recognize that they need to continue to stand up for the values of equality, fairness, and equal rights and justice for all. We remain committed to making sure we create economic opportunities for everyone by improving education, strengthening healthcare services, and improving financial literacy. An appropriate way to honor Dr. King is through service and volunteerism and really just engagement in civic activities. And by being part of action, one of the things Dr. Martin Luther King really said is that individual people can make a difference. Dr. King devoted his life to advancing equality, social justice, and economic opportunity for all. He challenged us to build a more perfect union and taught us that everyone has a role to play. So I would like to read the proclamation and then certainly invite everyone who's joined with me today to introduce themselves and say a few words and certainly share any events that may be upcoming. Whereas America has been blessed with heroes throughout our history, men and women of vision and courage who have set our feet firmly on the path of freedom and equality, some became heroes by leading us in times of struggle, some by shaping our values and challenging us to greatness, and a few, like Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., have done all of this and more. And whereas a thoughtful man and one of deep personal faith, his conscience called him into action for the soul of our nation. He mobilized thousands of other brave and principled Americans, black and white, renowned and unknown, and began a crusade for justice that continues today. In sit-ins, marches, demonstrations, and boycotts, he and many others met violence with nonviolence and ignorance with determination. They awakened the consciousness of our nation and succeeded in winning passage of historic civil rights legislation, the Civil Rights Act of 1964, the Voting Rights Act of 1965, and the Fair Housing Act of 1968. And certainly we need to continue to advocate for the intent of all of those pieces of legislation. Pouring out his life in service, Dr. King made enormous and lasting contributions to improve the lives of millions of his fellow Americans. And whereas, following his example of service, we must build communities where everyone shares an equal opportunity for a good education and a good job, and where we reject separation and isolation and instead celebrate our diversity together and the blessings that that provides. Now, therefore, as the County Executive of Frederick County, Maryland, I hereby proclaim Monday, January 16th, 2017, as Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Day in Frederick County and commend this observance to all of our citizens. So with that, I will pass the microphone, and I'm going to give it to you first, David. If you could introduce yourself and say a few words.
My name is David Key. I'm with the Arch Society of Frederick. I'd hope that we all take time to reflect on how fragile our relations, human relations, is in this country. I think that we've been reminded of that recently, and I know that most of the people standing here have worked hard at making sure that those relationships are firm, and we are who we are. We're much better than many of recent times have told us, and I think that it's just important that we continue to work not only in February but every day of our lives in making this a better place for all involved.
Okay, I'm Rose Cheney. I'm also with Arch and Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority and Asbury United Methodist Church and the Negro Business and Professional Women's Club, which we are having in Martin Luther King Luncheon tomorrow.
I'm Maria Boffman, and I'm here from Verita Real Estate.
Good morning. I'm Daryl Boffman. First of all, thank you, Jan Gardner, for hosting this event. Such an important opportunity to come together as a community and celebrate this holiday. I'm with Eliminating Achievement Gaps with Acela Technologies, and there are a host of others, but I'd like to mention that this evening at TJ High School, Frederick County Public Schools will be hosting a Martin Luther King Jr. Awards program, where there'll be students from all across the county at the schools who are given the award representing their school. But there's also great singing from the local choirs, as well as just an all-around great event to attend. So I hope you can make it. I believe it's at 6:30 this evening at TJ. Well, maybe they just need me there at 6:30. But 7 o'clock. For those of you who may get there late, let's just say 6:30. But thank you so much. And as a business owner, I always recognize the fact that I would not be where I am today had it not been for Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. And I hope that my walk in this life and what I do in this community reflects upon the kind of person that he is, because that's who I try to model myself after. So thank you.
I'm Annette Breeling. I am a fan of Martin Luther King's. I'm also a fan of Jan. I appreciate I'm a Jan fan. And I appreciate your putting forth the values of Martin Luther King. I'm involved with my faith group as a Quaker with Frederick Friends Meeting, and my outreach in a number of organizations in the community that work to advance the values of King. Human Relations Commission, the Homeless Coalition, the Immigration Coalition, Health and Human Rights, Health as a Human Right, and the Immigration. So I'm very involved right now in wanting to honor Martin Luther King on his day of service. At the end of the day, we're having a potluck, and it will be a community potluck where we're trying to bring in people of all elements in the community. And this event started 20 years ago after the Rodney King beatings, when there was a lot of unrest at that time, and Rodney King said, "Why can't everybody just get along?" And blacks and whites in the Frederick community decided we can get along over potluck, over food. And the food is good at this event. And anyone I invite anyone who's listening to come to that potluck at the Asbury Roses Church, the Asbury United Methodist Church, at 101 West All Saints Street. And we will look and not only enjoy potluck together, but think about ways we can advance King's belief in beloved community here in Frederick, how to uphold minority businesses, how to foster more minorities in elected offices in our politics, perhaps joining the organization Frederick Cares, or thinking about some unjust legislation, such as pre-trial bail that is unjustly affecting people in poverty if they get arrested, even if they're innocent, but they have to wait for trial and are too poor to pay bail. That is another issue of injustice that we're working to address. So I promote this event, which is Monday at 6 o'clock at Asbury United Methodist Church.
Good morning. I'm honored to be here. I'm Pat Fleet on the behalf of the Human Relations Department. So just honored once again to have everybody that showed up today, and very happy to see this group. And thank you all for coming.
Good morning. I'm Lee Wisner, and I am part of the Human Relations Commission. I, too, am honored to be here to honor Dr. Martin Luther King, Jr. And I just want to mention that I will continue to honor him and his leadership and what he has done for our country. I will continue to honor him with a day of service with myself and my two young sons, and we will honor him with service so that his memory will be honored.
Good morning. My name is Crystal Allen. I'm an AmeriCorps member with the Boys and Girls Club of Frederick County.
Good morning. My name is Willie Gardner, and I'm a member of Asbury United Methodist Church, Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority, Negro Business and Professional Women's Club, and many others. However, I'd just like to say how honored I am today to be here to honor Dr. Martin Luther King. As far as service, AKA, members will be joining the Boys Club and others at the Martial Arts Center on Monday from 10 to 1. Also, as Rose mentioned, we will be, as business professional women, we are celebrating Dr. Martin Luther King's birthday tomorrow with the luncheon.
Good morning, everyone. I am Angela Spencer, former chair of the Frederick County Human Relations Commission. I first just want to say good morning, Jan, Happy New Year, and everybody that's here. I stand here not only honored, but simply humbled, honestly. As I was thinking this morning and reflecting about Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., I thought about the dream. And I thought about the dream that I remember when I was in elementary school, it was recited and it was retold over and over again. And you would think that after the dreamer leaves, the dream dies. But it doesn't. The dream lives on, and it lives on through each of us who are standing here today and each of you who are watching today. So I encourage you to keep the dream alive. Not only have a day of service on Monday the 16th, but a day of service every day, because Dr. King marched not only for you and for me, but for everyone. So let's keep his dream alive. Thank you.
Good morning. My name is Dr. Travia Hayden. I'm here representing the medical community, the mental health community, and Delta Sigma Theta as their social action chairperson. I'm here to say that the medical community, mental health, and my sorority are heavily invested in promoting equality for all.
Dawn Stanton, member of the Social Action Committee for Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated, and also a small business owner here in our community. Again, we want to thank you, Your Honor, for having us here today and for acknowledging and recognizing the work of Dr. King.
Good morning, everyone. Tanya Amadon, Vice Chair of the Human Relations Commission, and I also work for the Housing Authority. Again, I want to say thank you for doing the proclamation. As I was thinking this morning as well, I was pondering on the fact that we're getting ready to change the hands in the political scene. And I'm reminded that we have to continue to live the dream that Martin Luther King fought for. We have to continue to be vigilant. We have to continue to just stand up for the things that are right in this country. We are one nation under God, and we just have to continue to just remember that as we move forward and continue to keep hope alive, continue to believe, and continue just to do exactly what you're told to do. Again, thank you, and God bless everyone.
Good afternoon. I'm Shana Knight with the United Way of Frederick County. Thank you, Jan, for having us here, and it's truly an honor to stand on this stand with Frederick's greatest leaders. I just wanted to say a MLK quote that always sticks with me, which is, life's urgent question is, what are you doing for others? And at United Way, we want to be the glue. We want to promote all of the opportunities next Monday that are going on, so you can find those on UnitedWayFrederick.org/MLK. And if you have an opportunity that is not up there that you would like us to share, please post it and share it and spread the word. Thank you.
Good morning. I'm Robin Washington. I live, work, and do community service in Frederick County. I'm a part of several organizations that where we give back on a regular basis. I am very honored to be here with the group as well today. I am born on Martin Luther King's birthday, so I'm a part of his dream. I always try to share that with everybody who I come across. But I thank you, Jan, again for having us here, and appreciate everyone here today.
My name is Dorothy Ja. And I'm here on behalf of an invite, and I thanked Pat for inviting us. And with an organization of Every Now and Then, where we help to serve the homeless and we go out to their campgrounds. And in order for us to be able to provide for them, God just placed it in our vision to carry on as the dream of Martin Luther King, to give back to others as we would to ourselves. So we just take that and we be able to let the legacy live on to what we are to do in this lifestyle that we live in. And we are reminded of that we are getting ready to change hands. So what we also have to remember is what he has instilled in us, we must carry on as his dream from day to day.
Good morning, everyone. I am Thaddeus Ja, co-founder of Every Now and Then Foundation. We advocate for the homeless. We are a community outreach program. I want to thank Pat for inviting us. And some of our members include Tanya Amadon, Sister Robin Washington, myself. Basically, what we do is that we get donations, and then we go on to the fairgrounds. We go to the homeless. Instead of having them come to us, we go to them. And when we do, what we do that is we first pray with them, because after we have left, we have left them by themselves. The everlasting thing is prayer. So we pray with them, and then we encourage them. And just like Dr. Martin Luther King, we serve to make other people's lives better. So thank you for having us.
My name is Craig Jean Grande. I'm a local business owner, a family business, Jeffrey Corporation, in the county. Also a member of Knights of Columbus and a volunteer with the Share Food Cooperative. And just wanted to come out, lived in the community for 25 years, and celebrate Dr. King's message of equality and respect.
Hi, I'm Lisa Clark. I'm on the Human Relations Commission. I'm also the director of the Frostburg State University AmeriCorps program, A-STAR in Western Maryland. I was trying to think of today how long we've been doing Martin Luther King projects with the AmeriCorps program, and thank you, because I didn't do the math correctly. It's been since 1994. We were one of the first AmeriCorps grants awarded in Maryland. So we have projects that happen from Garrett County all the way through Frederick. And in the past 7 years, we've decided to focus more on bringing our Western Maryland people to Frederick for a joint event, mainly because it snows too much in Garrett County and nobody can get out. So we've the last 2 years, we've hosted an event at the American Karate Academy on, it's 928 Northeast Street from 10 to 1. My husband owns a karate studio, so as a small business owner, he closes down for the day and allows us to take over, allows and or is helps us take over. And this year we will be making hats with Glory's Happy Hats. These hats are made from the beginning to the end. We trace them, we cut it out, we sew them together, and they're given to children in that are terminally ill in hospitals or are going to be there for an extended period of time. Last year we actually received a letter from a parent saying, you might not have thought your hats ever did anything, but my 13-month-old daughter smiled the whole time. Everybody called her a princess, and she wasn't afraid. And she said, as a parent, that made me feel better. So for the first time, I was like, wow, these really do something. I knew we were giving them out. I just didn't know that they actually reached people. And, you know, until you get a story back, it doesn't really happen all the time. We're also making blankets for cancer survivors and chemo patients. So we'll be doing that day, and we'll also have a collection box for Blessings in a Backpack, another local organization that provides backpacks to send home to children who might not have enough on the weekends. So we'll be doing 3 hours of service, any age, anybody's welcome to attend.
Hello, my name is Mary Lee. I'm representing the Human Relations Commission as chair, and I'm also representing the Commission on Disabilities today. We truly thank each and every one of you that have come out to support this proclamation. We truly appreciate that the county recognizes this event annually. We appreciate the organizations that stand for and march for what he believes in. Unfortunately, right now, I can't remember the quote that I wanted to say, but it talks about staying silent, but that's something the HRC will never do. We will never stay silent on things that matter, and civil rights is certainly one of those things that we truly are honored to fight for. Personally, I want to say that one of the quotes that I do remember that I live my life by, which is his quote that says, if you can't fly, then run. If you can't run, then walk. If you can't walk, then crawl. But at least keep moving forward. That is my motto because I have some disabilities. But no matter what, because of him and people like him, I'm going to continue to march forward for those things I believe in, as well as the HRC. Thank you all for being here today.
Thank you all for joining us. You can, all of our viewing audience, you certainly can see that there's a lot of people in our community doing a lot of good work to continue the work of Martin Luther King. But as we conclude, let us consider what Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. would be doing today if he were alive. Where would he be the most active? What would he say about the current state of affairs in our county or in America? One way we can keep his dream alive is to continue to work towards peaceful change, to reduce poverty, to ensure equal opportunity in economics and jobs, and you know, access to public education, which is the foundation of that prosperity. Dr. King was truly a leader who was committed to achieving social justice through nonviolent means. We continue to honor his memory and fulfill his dream by living it every day of our lives. So in conclusion, thank you for joining us. Please recognize Dr. Martin Luther King with a day of service and by making a difference in your community. Thank you for joining us.